Hello Libra, welcome new viewers, cross watchers and my lovely Moonians. Thank you so much for being here and happy 2020. May this year bring you abundance, success and happiness, and the intentions and resolutions that you set in January, may they all come true. Alright, so this is a reading for January 2020, the monthly reading. We will be looking into love and the spirit message which is coming through for you. First card coming through is the Three of Coins. And it's really interesting that I spoke about intentions, resolutions into manifestations, because with the Jupiter and Mercury conjunction, which is happening on the 2nd of Jan, it is bringing a new surge of ideas, and this is talking about put your talents into use. Now is the time that you put in the efforts rather than focusing on the rewards. They will be coming in. You have a clear sight, and now is the time that you start putting in the work for the rewards to come through. Apart from that, this could also be a time where you will start seeing the small saplings of the seeds you have sown in recent times. All right. So there is a bit of cards which are coming through. I will be doing this and see how they come through, because that is what was said. We have Temperance coming in, talking about balance and pulling in all that you are and bringing things into balance, counterbalancing also. And apart from that, this also talks about to just release any kind of fear or doubts that may be coming through, or hurt or guilt that may be there. Closure is important. You have to have a clean slate in order to move ahead. Apart from that, Temperance coming through also talks about perhaps you have been doing a lot of work and not getting enough time to focus upon yourself or spend time with family members or focus on your personal life, or vice versa. With the Three of Coins coming in reverse, this is talking about we have to put in a little bit of extra effort, which is coming through. This is a Sagittarian Major Arcana, and with that, I can say that on the 3rd, I am recording this on the 3rd, it's just crossed 12 o'clock. So on the 3rd, we have Mars also entering Jupiter. So this is a very creative time. What are the blocks that may be there? We have to unwind, relax, and then think creatively. Creative resolutions will be coming in. For some reason, that is coming through. We have the Two of Swords also coming through, which is talking about take your time, take everything into consideration. There may be new information coming through. The moment you put your mind onto something, you will start seeing everything orchestrating accordingly. If you want to study and you are looking for colleges, perhaps, like I'm just saying, you can take cue from it. It doesn't have to be college or student or whatever, but you're looking for colleges, and then suddenly you come across something which has a very good scholarship also, or perhaps you find a college which has the subjects that you're very passionate about. That kind of a thing is also coming in. But yeah, this is talking about doing your research before jumping into conclusion or making that decision. Take your time. There is no hurry is also what is coming through. Think. This is a thinking activation which is coming through over here. Take things into consideration. How are we managing our time? Can we pull in like the work that you're doing? Can we take out some time from that and put it into something that is very dear to you? That kind of a thing is coming through. We have Queen of Cups coming in reverse, which is talking about past healing, which is very important. Someone is looking at the back, at their past, and not being able to move forward. Even if their body is turned towards the future, I'm saying, but they have that body turned towards the front. Front word wasn't coming through, but their neck, they are still seeing at the back, that kind of a thing. So you can't really walk without looking ahead, and that is the energy which is coming through. Healing is very much required, which is coming in, which is why it was over here as well. And for some reason, I do not know why, I before the reading, because you are the last one which was left, before the reading I took like 3 hours before I could get to the reading, because the energy started becoming a little heavy. or the feeling of not being able to do as much. And I really couldn't understand why. Maybe you can relate. Maybe it's someone else who's feeling that way, which is why it's coming through. Because it was getting very difficult for me to navigate. I literally jumped for like 5 minutes to get the energy out of the system. And then I came to the reading. And now again, the energy is coming through. My videos are doing nice. I am on a healing process. I'm getting my channel back. I'm doing everything that I can to pull myself. And this was really weird because before I finished the Sagittarian reading, I was fine. Even after the reading, I was fine. But then suddenly there's this energy which came through. So if you are experiencing certain kind of heavy energy, it will be a nice time on the 10th of January with the lunar eclipse and the full moon in Cancer to really tap into your emotional world, reconnect with yourself, really think deeply what is still lingering on and what is stopping you to really access the kind of future and life that you really deserve, which you know you do. That, because full moons are very good for releasing, completion, closures, and you may like to utilize this energy because Cancerians are emotions. This one will be quite emotional or will show you your vulnerability. If there's any tyranny or oppression which is happening, you will feel like voicing or protecting yourself or protecting someone in your family or a family member who you know is sensitive, that kind of a thing. We have King of Coins also coming in reverse. When this comes in reverse, there's a little bit of short temper. Could be the other person is experiencing this. And with the Two of Swords coming in between right now at the moment, this is talking about keep your cool at the moment. Don't overly work your mind. And in a way, think, what am I doing wrong that this person is reacting in such a way? Or how on earth do I handle this kind of a tantrum which is going on, is also what is coming through. Let them be for some time if that is all that is required. Because with the Two of Swords, it also says that, like, you know, if you're not being able to decide or understand the current situation, leave it as it is for the time being. Come back after some time. There's no need to be overly heated by it or overly worked up by it. Stress is not going to do anything. It is only going to limit you or limit your vision or your capability to handle the whole situation, scenario in a different manner. That is what is coming through, all right? So we have three more cards. We have the Sun card coming through. So this is really nice. Bringing in the balance will be bringing in more clarity into your life is also what is coming through. What are we doing overly? Let's counterbalance that by bringing your attention to the other aspects also, is what is coming through. If you have been giving too much, then let's become open to receiving and vice versa. That kind of a thing is coming through because there is a lot of success which is coming in. So don't be impatient. There are new inspirations which will be coming in. Put them to use. If you can't do it right now, at least start jotting them down. And this has been coming in 2019 as well. Now is the time that you start doing it because success will be coming in. Don't delay yourself from what is coming to you. The more you prolong yourself, the more universe will be waiting for you to come through and prioritize as well. We have the Three of Swords coming through. So this is really interesting. Could be that there is certain kind of third party influence which is coming through. Whether it is someone being with someone else, a karmic relationship, a cycle. Third party influence is not only a person, but is also an element, an aspect, which is adding a lot of pressure on this person. Whether it is something on the past, which is still haunting them and is making them quite controlling and a little exaggerated and overly sensitive also. Could be like, you know, this person on the whole is a very genuine person, but right now they're very sensitive and maybe a little rash also. Not being able to control their anger because there's a source of their anger. There's an anger behind that anger. Could be there's a lot of work pressure which is coming through for this one. And they are feeling a little shook or shaken up with how the finances would be also is what is coming through. We have Eight of Cups coming in, which is really interesting. You know what? Even if there are the spirits right now, and I do not know why, I'm feeling very emotional for some reason. I have no idea why. This is talking about there's more to learn in terms of love as well. This person wants to discover new things is also what is coming through. For very few of you, it may be that someone is looking at other options also with the Three of Swords, because I'm not going to eliminate that out of the picture. Apart from that, that's why perhaps they have been a little distant and cold. Especially if it's a new one, they are still kind of influenced by their ex or their past relationship. They need to heal. They need to grow in order to come towards you. But with the colors over here, there's a lot of fiery yellowish energy which is coming through over here. Leo, Sagittarius and Leo energy coming through very strongly over here. There's a heart-to-heart which is very much important, very important. Because I don't want any kind of manipulation going on for people, for you guys who are so righteous, who like things black and white, and then the gray area is getting a little... I don't know. It almost feels like my... A major amount of healing is required. If you are in a relationship which wasn't really built on strong foundation, you may find it to be shaking right now, because the universe is really coming through and pulling you up from situations and toxic environments. That is what is coming through. Or perhaps the fact what I'm tapping into right now, wherein you are someone who's looking at this and you're feeling like this is not at all resonating with me. I'm in a very happy place. It could be someone else who's going through a lot and is not being able to express it in the right way. Perhaps the defense mechanism is such that they end up becoming very aggressive, and in turn you become distant from them, because at the end of it you offered a helping hand or an olive branch and they just retaliated, wherein they are struggling right now to even be happy. That kind of a thing is also coming in, because right now I can feel a weight on me, like really heaviness in my heart, very heavy. Okay, I'm just going to cleanse the energy a little, because this is getting to me now. We have faith coming through. So this is talking about having more trust. And with the Vista over here, they are willing to, or you are willing to have faith in what you both can offer to each other is also what is coming through. There is this very strong energy coming in. The last thing that I said about the channeled energy of someone really trying to help the other person but is not being able to help them. And perhaps that's where the confusion is coming in, and just realizing like, you know, if they want to get out of it, there is a limit to how much you can try. If the person is not mentally there at the moment, it won't really help is also what is coming through. But apart from that, I don't really see them to be manipulative. They are very simple people. That is the energy coming in from this person. But this energy is complicating the situation a little. Even if it isn't really about someone being there presently in their life, like apart from you, but there is something from the past and they're not being able to communicate with you clearly. All that is going on in their mind. They have a lot of anxiety coming through. We have the Lovers also coming in reverse, Gemini, Major Arcana. To those who have an inkling that there may be a third person, there may be a third person for sure. You just have to dig a little deeper. With the Gemini, Major Arcana coming in reverse and the Three of Swords, that is what is coming through over here. Perhaps you both aren't going to the next level just because the universe is also asking you to really look clearly before making a decision. That is the energy which is coming through. You know what's interesting? These two cards over here. One, this talks about someone being in the karmic relationship and will be taking a little longer before they can come towards you. Apart from that, when the Lovers card comes through, it talks about someone having enough faith in the other person that they're falling for. And we have faith over here, and we also have the thing coming in reverse. So in a way, it's also another contemplation which is happening. Like, you know, whether I trust this person or not. If you're having a hard time really understanding or just getting a cue as to what to do, go within. See what your heart says. See what your subconscious, higher self says. It's also what is coming through over here. We have the Wheel of Fortune coming in. So it's almost like there's a dip which is happening, then it goes up, then there's a dip which is happening and it goes up. That's the energy which is coming through. There are certain things, karmic cycles, loops, which have been repeating, and they will be repeating again till the time the universe doesn't see that you have actually learned the lesson. And that is exactly what is happening. Sweeping things which are no longer in sync with your life, an ending which is inevitable, whether internally or externally, for something more meaningful to come into your life. If there were delays, they will be coming to an end. This is a very nice time to travel as well. We have the Tower movement coming through. That's exactly what is happening over here. So the shaky foundations that I was talking about, this is saying that there was an ending which was inevitable. It had to end for those who are in a separation or recently left a relationship. Know that you knew somewhere or the other that it wasn't a solid foundation. And like, you know, somewhere or the other, you knew the stakes were high in a certain way. And it has happened only so that whatever was shaky goes out of your life so that the ground is leveled and you can build once again on a solid foundation. You are at a very pinnacle point of your life, whether or not you like where you are, but I can see a lot of changes which will be happening. And when the Tower comes in reverse, it talks about a storm which is passing. Some things which had to come to an end for new things to enter your life. Making space in your life. Internally letting go of certain set patterns of thoughts also. Changing negativity into positive energy. That kind of a basic essence is coming through over here. But be happy that the storm is passing and they are more than likely coming through and to speak the truth with you is also what is coming through over here. Someone has been taking some time to, or maybe has been a little away so that, like, you know, they can think more clearly because there was certain kind of past influence or third party scenarios, work related stress and all of that, which is really etching onto them. That is what is coming through. All I can say is that don't stress and have faith that the universe is looking out for you. Even if the immediate results of it are in sync with what you want or not, it is only happening because you are evolving and elevating. And with your elevation and ascension, your love life will also be ascending. When we change the way we love ourselves, we change who we attract into your life also. So that is the synergy which is happening right now. All right. So the card coming through is blessed coming in. Very lovely. 22 energy is coming in. I personally have been seeing a lot of two synchronicities also, which is talking about partnership, new kind of partnership. Similar energies coming in together with the twos getting repeated. Partnership is coming in. And what is really interesting is that, like, you know, when you add the two and two, so both are coming in with equal energies. And when you add the two and two, it gets a four, which is about stability, sanctuary, foundation, strong foundations, security as well, protection, guidance. And what I see is that even if there is something which is getting evaporated out of your life, there's something very beautiful entering also because you will be making space is what is coming through. I'll read this one. We have in exchanging gifts also coming through. Very lovely. Very lovely energy coming in. I'll quickly read these. And it's really interesting. When you add 5 to the 22, you get a 27. So the 5 signifies change. In order for this to grow, we need the equilibrium or equal amount of input into the relationship for it to nurture. And exchanging gift is like a barter system. Getting something from the other person and them buying something from you, that barter system is that, like, you know, equal amount of value. What you're giving in, you're also receiving, if not exactly, but the effort, the energy coming in from both the sides. Union is that, not just one-sided. All right? This says something wonderful that is unearned and unexpected, grace that is an unforeseen gift from spirit. The protection message which comes through is humility is called for now, as grace is an unearned gift. You didn't gain this by your own desires or actions. To be who you need to be, you can no longer do what you did. The change is inevitable. This also says, in a way, you have hit rock bottom, and what is required now is nothing less than total surrender. Then you will be blessed, is what is coming through. In terms of relationship, this says, you are moving toward a deepening of intimacy in a unique and sacred partnership. You know, you are meant to make this connection. This union, blessed by the divine, will bring transformation and beauty to the world. This is also a sign that, even more important, you are being called to a deeper intimacy with your own self and spirit. With this new development, you will see evidence of grace in your life, changing your vibrations, and with that, you are attracting different kind of people in your life. You are raising your standards. Have faith with whatever is happening. The ground may be shaking, but only to level things up so that we can build something more meaningful in our life, even if it is with the same person. All right? Exchanging gifts says the law of giving and receiving. Currency, trade-offs, weighing costs, and determining value. Wow, with my English right now. The protection message is, be careful what you pray for, because you just might get it and then realize you don't want to face the hefty price tag that comes with it. You may find yourself in a situation you've always desired but know you will have to walk away from, or even fail at it, because you can't or won't pay the dues it asks of you. If you want to be a famous musician, you have to practice your craft every day. Wow, okay. This is a long protection message, but we will be doing it, all right? That is exactly where we started with. And this protection message always comes through as an awakening that we may be doing a little less of something and we need to do it. So the spirit directly talks to you in a more like how a mother will talk to you, right? With a little less of sugarcoating and then more with the facts and with a lot of concern and love. If you want to be a millionaire, you have to be responsible for managing the money and paying the taxes. Even a windfall bears a cost. It's okay though, because spirit will help you achieve balance over time. We have balance also coming in with the temperance, tempering things down, moderating things a little for more harmony in our lives and more satisfaction. All right. This also says, another message here reminds you that being only the giver and not the receiver plays out in many relationships in your life where you find yourself in victim mode, in a codependent dynamic, or holding on to a false sense of control. Others may push you to continue to prove yourself. The time has come to distance yourself from this kind of imbalance. Being aware of the need for both give and take is the first step to your true destiny. It's all good and getting better. Not only can you handle this, but you can flourish as a result of it. Wow. very strong messages coming in. So see, it was a reality check which is happening. We need to do certain things. We need to put in the effort, bring in balance in our life, become aware of anything which is not really justice, doing justice by being in your life, moving them away, letting go of the uncertainties, having faith that things will work out in the best manner as they have to, and things will start moving ahead. The storm is passing, clearing your way is what is coming through over here. Very strong. Know that you are blessed. All right, so the first one coming through is imagination. Very lovely card. I think this is the first time this one has come through. I've never seen this card. All right. This says, envision a new reality. Give yourself permission to dream. Believe in unlimited possibilities. Have faith. You can achieve it all. All right. The second one is compassion coming in. Very interesting. With the person being a little angry, agitated, uncertain, we have compassion also coming through. Be gentle with yourself. Forgiveness will set you free. Wow. See the light in yourself and others. Forgiveness is what is required. Certain kind of guilt which is holding them back to really realize that they too deserve love and can be forgiven. They need to heal. That is also what is coming through. Use your imagination to set a new reality. Envision a new reality for yourself. Over here, we have a little more of compassion, starting with yourself. The love and respect that you expect from others, start bestowing that on your own self. Enjoy your time. Enjoy who you are. Bring out your authenticity. Let go of any kind of false sense of control that may be there. Let's look at the reality, put in the effort that is required, make the changes, do the conversations which are required, because it is high time that we clear the air and start moving forward. Either it is all in or all out. Let's not be in the shuffle of things. Let's become clear. Let's become more aligned with ourselves. You are a powerful and a very graceful being. You are ruled by, your sign is ruled by Venus, which embodies just all of these energies, the good ones which are coming through. Believe in yourself. Help the universe help you. All right. So do let me know if this resonated. This is quite a journey which is happening, but it is only for your betterment. You will see that in time. So until next time, many, many beautiful blessings, insight, clarity, and empowerment to you all. Om Namah Shivaya. Keep that vibe high, my lovely Moonians.